Hey there, I have Norton Commander for you. Version 3.0, to be exact. So take a look at this box. Okay, my camera work is not that good, but look at this, it's beautiful. You know, from the times when software came in boxes, and those boxes had cool stickers on them saying that it has additional software. Ah, well, those were the days. So this piece of computer history is written and designed by John Soka in 1984, and he was working on the software for about 5 years. But before that, he was contributing to the PC society with useful utilities like a screensaver or a keyboard buffer extender. And there was another one called Varies. It was a Finder utility. The first version of the file manager was entirely in assembly, but that was too time-consuming, according to Soka, so he switched to a blend of C and assembly. At that time, most quote-unquote real programmers wouldn't touch C. That's what he said in an interview. It was originally called VDOS or Visual DOS because it meant to be a shell for DOS. But of course, after joining Peter Norton's company, it became the Norton Commander. Now, let's take a look at the box. Oh, yeah. It's a special message to the purchasers of the Norton Commander 3.0. Well, you can pause the video and read this thing. It's hilarious in 2015. Oh, a lot of phone numbers. I guess it predates email. Ordered direct from Peter Norton. Yeah, tell us your credit card number and expiration date and everything, and send it back in a simple envelope. That's cool. Oh yeah, the license agreement. You can pause the video and read this as well. I'm not going to open this yet. Oh, look at this, it's so soft. And there's a book, a manual. Well, look at this. You don't really get these things nowadays with software. Well, software, you know, it's not even coming in boxes anymore, so. Cool picture. Very monochrome-ish. And of course a photo. And we have the discs here. 3.5 inches and 5.25 inches discs. Oh, they're so cool. You know, they're called floppy discs. Let's install Norton Commander. I wanted to use my 486 for this, but real-time clock battery went bad. So stupid Micronics motherboard BIOS, it can't even boot because every time I turn it on or try to, you know, boot the thing, it doesn't do anything, just resets to the default BIOS settings and tells me to take a look at the real-time clock battery. And I'm way too lazy for that, so I'm just gonna use a virtual machine. There's another thing, the 3.5 inches disk. It's not working. I even bought this USB floppy drive because I thought my original drive went bad. Well, no, so I'm gonna stick to the 5.25 inches disks. It's gonna take so much time, but at least you can listen to the drive. It sounds cool. After inserting the disk, you only need to type in install. And then it will bring up the installer for the Norton Commander. You hit a bunch of OKs, select the drive from where you want to install the software, and then specify the path where you want to install the software. And while it is copying files, I can tell you that there were a lot of versions of the Norton Commander. Version 3.0 brought in a lot of new features, but there There was, I think the last version was 5.0 for DOS, and then they restarted the version numbering. So there was even a version for Windows NT and this product line called the Norton Commander for Windows, as you can see. After restarting the computer, you only need to type in NC, and then it will open up Norton Commander for you, and you can select files and deselect them and whatnot. Now, one of the cool features that it brought in was directory tree. So let me create some directories here quickly. And this was not new back in DOS days. There was a software called Xtree that had the same directory structure for navigating, but it's cool that Norton Commander brought in this feature. So as you can see, there's our directory tree, and we can navigate from directories to another directory. It didn't display files. So as you can see, I'm creating a file here, whatever. Oh, it's not gonna work. We created, okay. And as you can see, there's no file. But it had a quick viewer, and well, I only have text files here, but it was able to open up Lotus 123 and spreadsheets and a bunch of other formats. It was really cool because you didn't have to open up anything to view the contents of a file. I think it's pretty convenient. So now there's another thing. It supported EGA mode, but it looks ugly, so I'm gonna switch back. And if you didn't have a colored display, it supported black and white as well. Now, if you happen to have a laptop with a crappy display, these white selection of files, it just didn't make any sense. So if you select laptop screen colors, then you will have little rectangles next to the selected files. Crappy displays for the win. Remember what I told you about screensavers? Take a look at this. It's beautiful. It's a built-in screensaver for the Norton Commander version 3.0. The black sky with blue stars. Man, I could watch this for hours, but I don't have time for that. The Commander Mail, or MCI Mail, it was something to send and receive faxes. I'm not sure if it supported faxes in this version, but in later versions, it did. And wow, okay, clear text passwords. That's funny, whatever. MCI ID, I never used this, to be honest, but that's pretty straightforward, so you can select modems and everything. Oh yeah, please create those directories for me so I can delete them later. It even had an address book. And I guess it did support fax. Fax thingy, no notes. Okay, well, it doesn't really matter. And I think it was intelligent enough. Yeah. It was really cool back then to have this thing. It's 1989, so, you know, GUIs were not really on back then. It's always funny to read the last minute notes. And, well, It's not that funny, actually. But there were clones. And the one that I'm going to talk about is Volkov Commander. It actually copied Norton in every way. And of course, it had some cool features like these opening of the panel animations. But it lacked a lot of features like built-in editors. It used the MS-DOS edit. And it was just, you know, a clone. But it was totally okay for someone who just wanted to browse files and then hit enter and execute them. So that was it about the Norton Commander version 3.0. Thank you for watching the video. I'm planning on doing another one, a better one, with Windows 3.0. I have that in a box as well, and a bunch of other softwares and even a cool retro computer from a country that you might never even heard about. So stay tuned, and again, thank you for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.